Today we're going to look at strong hypergraph colorings. A strong coloring is a hypergraph coloring where adjacent vertices are assigned different colors. To demonstrate, the coloring shown here is not a strong coloring because vertices A and B share an incident edge and were assigned the same color, blue. Here's the same hypergraph with a strong coloring. Notice that our strong coloring is also a proper coloring of the hypergraph, which is a coloring where no edge of size 2 or greater is monochromatic. This is true in general because if a coloring is strong, then an edge of size k will use k colors, meaning every edge of size greater than 1 will not be monochromatic. Another useful fact about strong colorings is that a strong coloring of the hypergraph will always be a proper graph coloring of the 2 section of that hypergraph, and vice versa. Moving on, we define the strong chromatic number of a hypergraph to be the minimum number of colors required for a strong coloring of the hypergraph. Since all strong colorings are proper colorings, it must be that the strong chromatic number of a hypergraph is greater than or equal to the chromatic number of that hypergraph. Also, because of the equivalence of a hypergraph strong coloring and a proper graph coloring of its 2 section, the strong chromatic number is equal to the chromatic number of the 2 section. This fact is useful because it means that finding the strong chromatic number of a hypergraph is equivalent to finding the chromatic number of its 2 section. As an example, if this is our hypergraph, to find its strong chromatic number, we only need to find the chromatic number of its 2 section. The 2 section happens to have chromatic number 4, and the following is a proper 4 coloring of the graph. Therefore, our hypergraph has strong chromatic number 4. Moving on, let's look at a connection between strong colorings of hypergraphs and proper colorings of graph squares. Recall that the square of a graph G is the graph with the same vertex set as G, in which 2 vertices are adjacent when they're at distance 2 or less in G. Properly coloring the square of G is equivalent to coloring G in a way that vertices at distance 2 or less are given distinct colors. This is known as a distance 2 coloring. Now, connecting this to hypergraph strong colorings, from a graph G, we can form the closed neighborhood hypergraph of G, N sub G. This hypergraph has the same vertex set as G, and the edge set is the set of all closed neighborhoods of vertices in G. It turns out that a strong coloring of this neighborhood hypergraph is a proper coloring of the square of G, and vice versa. To show this, suppose we have a strong coloring of N sub G. If 2 vertices A and B are adjacent in the square of G, then in G, they were a distance 2 or a distance 1. If they were a distance 1, then they were in each other's closed neighborhoods, meaning there's an edge that contains A and B in hypergraph N sub G. Therefore, A and B receive different colors under our strong coloring of N sub G. If they were at distance 2, then there's some vertex C that they're both adjacent to, meaning both A and B are in C's closed neighborhood, which again means there's an edge that contains A and B in the neighborhood hypergraph. So they receive different colors under our strong coloring. We can now say that any pair of adjacent vertices in G squared receive different colors under any strong coloring of the neighborhood hypergraph, which is another way of saying that all strong colorings of the neighborhood hypergraph are proper colorings of G squared. In the other direction, every proper coloring of G squared is a strong coloring of N sub G. To show this, suppose that we have a coloring of N sub G that's not strong. That is, there's an edge that has at least 2 distinct vertices A and B assigned the same color under our coloring. This edge must be the set of vertices in the closed neighborhood of some vertex in G. Let's refer to that vertex by V. We now know that in graph G, there exists a pair of vertices, A and B, in the closed neighborhood of some vertex that are given the same color under our coloring. The fact that A and B are in the closed neighborhood of a vertex means they're a distance at most 2. So in G squared, A and B are adjacent but assigned the same color, meaning our coloring is not a proper coloring of G squared. We can now say that if a coloring of N sub G is not strong, then it's not a proper coloring of G squared. But considering that every coloring of G squared is a coloring of N sub G and vice versa, this statement's equivalent to, if a coloring of G squared is proper, then it's a strong coloring of N sub G. Interestingly, proper colorings of graph squares and hypergraph strong colorings see applications in communication networks. In this application, stations are modeled as vertices, and neighboring stations, as well as stations that share a common neighbor, are required to have different frequencies to avoid interference. In this context, a strong coloring of the neighborhood hypergraph, or a distance 2 coloring of the graph, is an allocation of frequencies to stations that satisfies these constraints. I'll link some resources to this application in the description. I encourage you to think about other applications of hypergraph strong colorings and share them in the comments. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day!